years. So we learned how can we divide a decimal by a whole number, isn't it? So in this video, I will tell how can we divide a decimal by 10, 100, and 1000. 10, 100, and 1000. Very simple. Okay. Before we go for the division of decimal numbers, what is the relation between the multiplication of decimals by 10, 100, and 1000, and also what is the between the division of decimal by 10, 100, and 1000? That means what is the relation between their multiplication and division with the 10, 100, and 1000? If you know these things, then you can do any questions like by 10, 100, 1000, whatever it is. Okay, you can do it. So we already learned how can we multiply, isn't it? So what are the things we learned? Just here you can check it. If you are multiplying a number 3.4 into 10, what happens to the decimal point, isn't it? What happened to the decimal point? Okay, if you are multiplying 3.4 with the 10, in 10 we have 10, isn't it? This is multiplication. I will comes to the division after explaining it. Okay, then you will get to understand what is the relation between what happens to the point. Okay, 3.4 into 10. Okay, 3.4 into 10. So 3.4 into 10 means here 10 have 10. In 0.4, how many decimal points? 1 decimal place, isn't it? So when we multiply it with the 10, that means it carries 10. Then what happened to the decimal point? It shifts to the right. Okay, it moves to here. That means become 34 point. That means what? No number is there after the point, means you can simply write 34. Okay, when you multiply with the zeros, multiply with the 10, 100, 1000, it always shift to the right. Okay, shift to the right places. Okay, so that is the thing. The point shift to the right. Okay, so for example, another example, 3.4 into 100. 3.4 into 100. First, we know that in the case of 10, for this zero, it can shift to one places. That means it's become 34 first. Okay, one more zero is there in 100. So there is no other digit there for decimal to carry, isn't it? So that time we have to put a zero. It's become 340. This one we already learned, isn't it? Okay, so this is the case of multiplication. One more thing. Okay, if it is 2.125, when you multiply with the 10, when you multiply this number with the 10, it will shift to one decimal point. That means become 21.25. Isn't it 21.25? The same one, if you multiply with the 100, how many decimal points it can move? 1, 2. Okay, so it's become 212.5. Correct? This point moves to 212.5. When you multiply it with the 1000, it moves to 123. So we will get a answer 2125. Understand? If you multiply again it with the 10,000. First it moves to here 1, 2, 3, it is already moved, then 10 is remaining, that you have to put there. So this is the rule for multiplication. When we comes to the division, the opposite of it is happening. That means, I'm taking a number, 2.3 divided by 10. So I'm going to divide this number. So when I'm dividing, what is the opposite of it? First it moves to here, right, isn't it? When we multiply, it moves to the right side. Here, when we divide, this point moves to here, this side. Understand? Okay, so it's become 2.3, it's become what? 0.23 or 0.23. Understand? Okay, again, I'm taking 2.56 divided by 10. See, this simply 10 means 2.56. Simply 10 means what will happen? It's become, this one moves to here, it's become 0.256. Same rule. Okay, then if it is a 2.3 divided by 100. 2.3 divided by 100. So I told you first, for this zero, this will move to one decimal point. You see, it moves to one decimal point. Again, one more zero is there. When we multiply, one more zero comes, means we'll put 10 on the right side. Here we have to put 10 on the left side, because these decimals can only move to here. There is no other digits there to move, isn't it? So that time we have to put our number have 2 zeros. 10 can move to this decimal place. It can be 0.23, but one more zero is there, so you have to put 10 there and write the 0.23 here. Point will comes. Understand? Two decimal place it goes. Understand? Here point 2.3 become 1.2. 0.023 will be the our answer. Understand? So this is actually in the case of multiplication and division. Okay. One more example. I'm taking a same number. Okay. 1.215. 1.215 divided by 10. Okay, what will be the answer? 1.215 divided by 10. Okay, so what will be the answer? Our answer, this point moves to here. Understand? So our answer becomes 12.15. Okay, same number, 1.215 divided by 100. What will be the answer? Point first moves to here, then here. Understand? So it's become 1.215. You can change, you can find the changes, isn't it? How many decimal points it moved? You can find it here. 1.2. Understand? You can check yourself. 1.215. Here 1.215 divided by 1000. Okay, divided by 1000. Okay. 1.215 divided by 1000. Sorry, one not 1.215. 1.215 divided by 1000. Okay, we are going to divide this number by 1000. What will happen? First it moves to 1, 2, then here. Understand? 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. So 0.1215. Okay, again this number, if we are going to divide with the 1000, 10,000, 10,000, any 1000, no problem. Okay, so 0 is there. So how many places? 1, 2, 3, 4 is there, isn't it? So 1, 2, 3. Up to here we can put the point, because after that there is no number. Then what we have to do? One more 0 that you have to put there, write the digit 1, 0, 1, 2, 1, 5. Here you have to put. This is the answer. You can see that 4 decimal places. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Actually, this is 0.5 already. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 0, 4. Okay, so this is our answer. So just to count the number of zeros, shift it like that. If there is no number, just put 0 and make the point here. So this is the division of a decimal by 10, 100, and 1000. Okay. Okay, in your textbook, one question is there. Okay. So the question is, find the quotient. Okay, find the quotient. 43.75 by 10. Okay. So what is the quotient? You can simply write the quotient like this way, isn't it? 43.75 by 10. What is the answer? 1, 0 is there, so it moves to here. It's become 4.375. So this is our answer, 4.375. You can find this way. Our answer is given, that is our quotient. But this is simple method. But in your textbook, one more method is given, that is usual division. This also you can use, but this is simple way to find out. But this the division method also you must know. Okay. So that I will explain to you how we are finding this one, 4.375 by usual division method. Okay, so this is our answer. You can easily find 1 0 is there, 43.75 shift to 4.375, we will get answer. Okay, so how can we get this answer? By usual division method. So our question is 43.75 divided by 10. Find the quotient. Okay, when we divide, what are the changes? This kind of numbers usually we do not divide easily. So how what we have to do is we have to write 43.75 divided by 10. This is our question, isn't it? So I'm going to find the answer. Okay, so here this is 43. Understand this part first, we have to take our number is 10, isn't it? So 43, how many tens makes 40? 4 tens, isn't it? 43. Then subtract, you'll get a 3. Understand? Next part is very important. Okay, we go to 3, we cannot divide, isn't it? So we have to take water. How to take which one? 7, isn't it? That time it is actually on where? After the point. Okay, so that time we have to put a point here. Then write the result. Okay, then how many times? 3 tens are 30. Then usually you have to go So we have to put the point when we take the number after the point. We have to put a point on the quotient when we take the number that is after the point on here. Understand? That is only the thing. So 30 we will get it, then 3 minus 3, sorry, 7 we will get it, sir. Okay, then we will get it. But what is next one? 7. That is only 7, 5. We will get it. How many times? Yes. Okay. 7 times we will get it, then 70. Then subtracting, we will get a 5. Okay. This how many 5? 0 we have to put, then we will get 5. Okay. So we will get a 50. Okay. So this is the one. That means you may think that how we got to 50 here. If there is no decimal here, means you can put any 0 here, isn't it? If there is no number, if there is no number here, means you can put any 0. 4.43.750000. You can put it. There is no number there. Zero comes in between the number of the value. That's why I put a zero here. Then 5 times 10, you can make a 50, you get answer. Okay. So 4.375. So we go to quotient 4.375 by division method. Okay. Or you can directly go for this one. Okay. So this one also you must know how I did. Okay. So that is about the division of numbers by 10, 100, and 1000. Keep these things in your mind. Okay. Repeatedly watch this video because maybe you get confused, and if you are noticing these things on somewhere, okay, take only one example. Division of multiplication of decimal by whole number, take one example. Multiplication of decimal by a decimal, division of decimal by a whole number, division of decimal by decimal, like that, decimal by 10, 100, like that. If you are writing one examples each, means you will keep these things in your mind. Okay. So that's all for today. Thank you.